Okay, so before jumping into today's topics, we have still a couple of minutes left over from what we did 2 weeks ago, was that? And concerning the implementation of this application that basically was working for all the functionality that were planned. Also the edit button, we learned how to pre-fill a form with some initial values that can be modified by the user. And so these values can be modified and saved into the global state. There was a bug in this implementation, and had to do with the fact that if I click on edit and then cancel and edit another item, of course the new item will show up. But if I click on another edit button of another row, or the third one, while the second one is open, okay, nothing happens. Nothing seems to happen, okay? But if I modify something in this and save it, what happens is that it will be saved in the position of the third element, not the second one. So actually, I did switch to the third element, but the initial value of the form were not reloaded in a way. To see what happens, it's easy to inspect, for example, this form. I try to edit the first one, so you have this edit or answer, add or edit answer component that contains some state values, and the state values, of course, are for the different input elements that for controlling them, and the properties, okay, and the properties, in particular the initial value property that was set when I click on the edit button. Okay, that's good. And actually the current state, the initial state of the state variables, date, text, and author, are copied from the initial value. That's by design. What happens if I click on another button here? If I click down here, the initial value, you see they are changing because I'm changing a property that is being passed to the component. The component is re-rendering, of course, because the property changed, but the state variables didn't update. That is because the state is initialized only when it's created. Initialization means that. The first time I create a state variable, I will apply the initial value from the use state call. If I'm, just to look at the code, we have a, an answer form here. This prop.initial value are used only when we are creating a new state variable. If I change in the properties, I'm just updating a props of a component. The component is re-rendered by the state is persistent. Well, that's the reason why we have the state. Okay? So what happens is that the property change, and so also the ID of the element being edited is updated, but not the content of the form. Because the content of the form is bound to a state, and this state is not sensitive. It does not, there's no way that the state can understand that the props has changed, and so with a change of properties, the state should be recomputed in a way, or reinitialized, okay? There's no such notion. Inside a component, you can never ask yourself, did the prop change compared to last time? Just because the props are the functional part of the React flow. And so in the functional execution of code, there's no notion of before or the previous value. There's only the current value. So we have no way here to detect that the props changed And so we need to do something because the approach changed. Actually, this is a mistake in our, let's say, design, because we thought that by changing the properties, we can inject an initial value into a form. Okay, we cannot do that only when we create the component from scratch. And that is why we have no problem when we close and reopen the form on a different row, because that component is destroyed when it's no longer rendered. And when I click on the editor, I'm creating a new component instance that will have its own different state. Okay? So, in general,